Welcome to Johnny Tutorials. We are back with the Croc 1 discussion of histology. So most probably we have completed how many questions? We have completed 5 questions. So this is the continuation class of the Croc 1 histology. Histology Croc 1 discussion. So every day we will be discussing 15 questions from the histology and 15 questions from the anatomy. Because anatomy and histology are very good brothers, right? So we have to treat them equally. So if brother is okay, then sister is also okay. If they are both are not okay, then nothing will be sorted out. Just take out that histology and give me ma.
Okay, right.
So listen guys. So we are going to study about the histology Croc 1 discussion. So most of the people are asking, bro, why you are discussing 5 questions and why you are again and again they are asking the question. Again and again they are asking the question for 5 questions or 6 questions. Why are you taking 45 minutes and 35 minutes? Okay, watch a movie. 3 hours, you can watch a movie. Chat, no problem. But 35 minutes, I am taking the time, right? So that 35 minutes, it doesn't mean that only I am giving you the all the false statements like regarding only that question. That question I am relating with the correlating topics. Let it be. See, if I am doing anatomy, like yesterday we were doing anatomy. So there will be some help from the histology. There will be some help from the other subjects and other streams also. So no need to be worried. Everything will be fine. Everything will be fine. Okay, we are going to start from the 6th question of the histology. Yes, come on. So up to 5th question, we have finished in the histology. Not 5th, 6th questions, I think so. No. We'll start from the 6th only. 5 questions we have finished. So now we are going to start with the 6th question. Okay. So today we are going to complete which questions? 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. 15, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So from question number 6, we are going to complete up to question number 20, okay? So last time we have discussed, right? After the 5th question, we have discussed like granulomas with Michaeliskus cells. Granulomas with Michaeliskus cells, which is also. So in the 5th question, last time when I discussed about the histology, in the 5th question, you need to not only concentrate with granulomas with Michaeliskus cells, you need to see that because this is almost asked question in the Croc 1. That is, Michaeliskus cells, Virchow cells, Langerhans cells, and foreign body cells and interstitial inflammation. Because whenever you are studying your mnemonics, Croc mnemonics, it means keyword in the question and answer in the option. So whenever you are studying this mnemonics, I think in the mnemonics these questions will be there. That too in the pathology, that too most in the path morphology. So now we are going to start our class now. Okay, come. Read the question. Take your books, take your pens, note down everything, make pictures. Don't write, because writing will not help in any way. Diagrammatic with writing will help in a proper and fantastic way. Come on. Lung of a premature infant is presented on electronic photomicrography of biopsy material. Okay. See. Electronic. Zoom it when I'm writing, okay? Electronic photomicrophotography. It's like you are observing. See this guy is there. He's a pathologist and he's observing something. Okay? He's observing something here, okay? Like they said, this. So what is called biopsy? What do you mean by biopsy? Biopsy. Examination of something, anything that you wanted to examine, let it be a tissue, let it be a small tissue, let it be a small t- tissue and we have to see the structure of the tissue, whether it's got inflamed or not. We have to see in the electronic photomicrography and we have to tell whether this tissue is getting inflamed or not. I think you can see whenever you have the kidney related pathologies, your doctor will do the biopsy. He'll put a syringe in the backside. And he will take small part of the nephrons and he will do the biopsy. So there you can easily tell that is he okay or not, is there been any etiology in the kidneys. So we are going to so up to biopsy material we have to. So what material we have here? We have the biopsy material over here. Okay, we have the biopsy material over here. And collapse of alveolar caused by the deficiency of surfactant was revealed. Okay, surfactant was revealed. See, listen, this is your lungs. Respiratory system. So primary bronchus, tertiary bronchus is leading into the structural and functional unit of the lungs, which is called alveolus or alveolocyte. So I'm zooming this part. So this will be your alveoli in a proper round shape. Okay. See, you know that gaseous exchange mostly takes in the viscous parts of the alveolar side. Exactly, gaseous exchange will be taking there. So whatever you are taking, the pure oxygenated oxygen from the atmosphere, it will go into your lungs. From the lungs, it will be exchanged into your body, because blood is having many functions to carry, right? So blood is necessary for our body to transport nutrients, hormones, so and so, pharmacological drugs, everything. So oxygen also one part of that. So our blood also need oxygen to be transported. So come on, let's go with the question now. See, we have the lungs, we have taken the biopsy, and we are observing. This is the electronic photo micrography, and this pathologist guy is watching it. What's happening with that biopsy material, whatever he has taken from that. Collapse of the alveolar wall, he told. Oh yes, collapse of the alveolar wall. So this wall is there, right? This wall has been collapsed. This wall has been collapsed, so the wall alveolar, the wall will be like this. When there is a collapse of the wall, whether the exo and endo functions will be happening. Tell me, Ajin, whether the functions will be happening. No! Functions will not be happening. Some problem is there. Some morphological structure has been changed due to some pathogenesis, etiology, causes. And alveolar wall caused by the deficiency of surfactant. Surfactant. There should be some surfactant like here. The surrounding material. And dysfunction of what cells of the alveolar wall caused it? See, in lungs we have two types of cell. Those are alveolocyte type 1, alveolocyte type 2. And what this type 1 is doing and what this type 2 is doing? Concentrate, important, all time asked question. See, put 3 marks, 3 stars. Put 3 stars, all time asked questions. So, alveolar site in this is asking the main material, which cells are participating in the surfactant of the collapse of the alveolar membrane, the structure. There will be, if there is no alveolar site over here, surfactant will be lost, of course. Surfactant will be lost. So, there is a problem of the alveolar site 1. No, sorry. Alveolar site 2. This alveolar site 2, there is a problem. See, this cell is there. This cell is there, okay? It's very happy before it was got inflamed. So now, when it got inflamed, now it's crying. So there is some alveolar deficiency have suffocant. Suffocant is not produced over there. So the alveolar side, the structural and functional unit of the lung tissue, alveolus, Latin language, alveolus, it's not, this alveolus type 2, alveolus type 2 is not there. Something happened to it. So it's gone. So he's asking that what is a particular cell is taking part in the suffocant? Of course, it's alveolar site 2. Alveolar site 2. The answer is alveolar site 2. What is alveolar site 2 do? See, for example, this is a cell. This is a cell of alveolar site type 2. What it will do? It will do its vomiting. It will do its vomiting. It will do its vomiting. That is called produces suffocant. Produces suffocant. And we have the other cells also, like alveolar type 1, alveolar macrophages. See, yes, alveolar macrophages are very important. Whenever you have with the problem in the hypersensitivity type 1 reactions, if there is any dust allergy entering, if there is any foreign body particles which are entering inside, these alveolar macrophages, they come as a soldiers and they will rescue our lung tissue. Like any bacteria which is entering into the lungs and the soil, this alveolar macrophages will take. So we are having different types of cells. If it is there is any inflammation or any infection in the liver, which cells will take part? Kupffer cells, important, right? This is there in the Kroc. The next question, I think you'll get in the Kroc base book, this question. Kupffer cells. Okay, the question is finished. Come on, let's go for the next question. The question number is 6 or 7? Rajne?
7.
Huh?
7.
7 question, right? Very good, Chandu. Right, you're listening. Come on, we'll be going to the 7th question. No, 6 we are finished. During the histological examination of the stomach, it was found out that glands contain very small amount of parenteral cells or they are totally absent. Yes, very interesting question. This is your stomach. What is it called? Avinashi, padra.
Stomach.
Okay. What is telling that it was found out that glands contain very small amount of parental cells or they are totally absent? We have some parental cells. What are these? Which are lined to the smooth vascular structures of the stomach. Parental cells. Cells are nothing but gland cells. Right, write down the cells. Gland cells, which will be mostly, I think in the pharmacology, you'll be getting a topic like PPH. PPI means proton pump inhibition. We are going to learn this in the antacids drugs. So there you are going to discuss about these parental cells. So, you'll discuss in that topic when we start pharmacology, topics day by day, okay, first. But we have to go with the Kroc, right? So, we shouldn't waste the time. So, what we have, this is the stomach. So, what I told before studying about any organ, you need to study about what? Anatomy. You should know the anatomy of the stomach and then you go for the histology. Yes or no? So, what is the anatomy of the stomach? What stomach consists of parts? What are the parts we have in the stomach? What is this part called? 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 The first part, it is called as cardiac part. Yes, because cardiac part. Because it is near to the somewhat cardiac position, it's called cardiac part. And the next question is fundus. Fundus is present under the cardiac part. And the next question is called the body. What do you call body in the Latin? So we are a Ukrainian doctor, means posh doctor, So we have to use posh language. So we use Latin language. So body means corpus. Corpus. Corpus or body. Cauda also we can say. Cauda is the tail. Cauda also we have to use when there is a, whenever you find in the anatomical organ like any labeling type. So whenever you see a tail, so don't call it a tail. You are a posh doctor, call it as cauda. See. Okay, glands contain very small amount of parental cells or they are totally absent. Yes, these cells are absent. So what's going to happen? When these cells are absent, what's going to happen? So let's see what's going to happen. Membrane of what part of the stomach was studied? Yes. So you have known about the labelings of the stomach, right? So the cells will be like this, like this, like this, like you guys. These all are the cells. These all are the cells. Whenever you eat any gastritic, like very spicy food, very spicy food, the food will be entered like this, like this, like this, like this, like this, like this, like this. And this is the pyloric part. Pyloric part. Pyloric part. Because this part is very wide, so the problem of inflammation will be somewhat less because the space is more. See the diameter? The space is more, but you have the less space over here. So whatever this the like any gastritic inflammation, for example, we have in the pathology like erythromatous inflammation, erythromatous gastritis, it is what I have told. It is means inflammation. What is the difference between inflammation and infection? First, don't get confused with inflammation and infection. It's having a different. Inflammation is some morphological structures of the changes of the cells due to some pathogenesis, due to some etiology, due to some causes which are coming from outside. There are some causes which are also happening in our body, like autoimmune infections. If there is no proper immunological system working in your body, then it of course leads from the inside also the infection. No, inflammation. The inflammation comes from outside also. But the same manner, we have the infection from inside, we have the infection from outside. So in the infection, mostly bacteria and microorganisms, all foreign bodies will be involved. Yes or no? But whereas in the inflammation, only cells will be involved because we are studying pathomorphology. Pathomorpho means shape. Pathophysiology. Physiology means the water content, what's getting happened there. Say, I'm a person. This is my stomach. So I'm studying my anatomy. Next, histology. I have some pathogenesis. So I entered some pathogenesis of my stomach. So I'm looking into my stomach. Okay, I have to study what is the pathogenesis, inflammation, what is the inflammation. So I'm going into my stomach and watching there. I've seen that path morphology somewhat changed. But unless until you don't know the path physiology, then what you're going to see? If you're treating the path physiology normally, then you're about to treat the path morphology. So go in a step, but treat path physiology, then go for path morphology. What is happening in the path physiology? The chemical reactions, what are the dirt chemical reactions or what are the pathogenesis which is taking inside the cell? They're having cells. Cell, group of cells form tissues, group of tissues form organs, group of organs form organ systems. How many organ systems we have? Like around 12 or 13 or something, I don't know, I don't remember, but we have different types of organ systems. Okay, membrane of what part of the stomach was studied? Yes, of course, whenever we are talking about the parental cells, mostly the cells will be discussed about in the parietal part. This part, the tail part of this stomach. The tail part of the stomach, exactly this place, the parental cells sometimes doesn't produce what? Glands. Glandic secretions. Means glandular secretions will be stopped. Glandular secretion, glands, glandular secretions has been pathogenic. Okay, so let's go for the next question. So I think we have finished the seventh question. Now we are going for the eighth question. Okay, eighth question. Live wax is injected into the human body, increasing the activity of what cells of the connective tissue can be expected? Yes, whenever, see, we have got the problem, now the pandemic situation of this corona, we have been taking vaccine. What this vaccine is going to do in the body? How this vaccine is going to act in the body? Whenever you take the vaccine, which cells are coming? Which cells are fighting? That we are going to study. Okay, what we have given to that guy? Vaccine. Vaccine we have given to that guy. So after giving the vaccine, what's happening? Human body? Yes, we have given to the human body. Okay, we have given to... His name is Inderbit Singh. Inderbit Singh. Who gave him the vaccine? B.D. Chaurasia gave. B.D. Chaurasia gave him the vaccine. So Inderbit Singh is very angry. Like we have taken the vaccine, right? So what's happening to this IV? Injected into the body, increasing the activity of what cells? In his body, see. In his body, some activity is increasing. But Avinash, increasing or not?
Increasing.
Increasing the activity of what cells of the connective tissue can be expelled? Yes, for example, see. I'm going to study about this Inderbit Singh. Inderbit Singh is telling that, Sira Macha, I have this tissue. In the tissue, I have different types of cells. In that, I have the fibroblasts, blah, 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 and we have the connective tissue here. Connective tissue. Inderbit Singh is telling. Because Inderbit Singh is getting vaccinated by the B.D. Chaurasia. Okay. Because we are studying anatomy, so B.D. Chaurasia. So now we are studying the histology, so Inderbit Singh. These are the authors of our India, okay? Sorry to take their names, but to keep the concepts clear, I'm just using, so please don't mind. Increasing the activity of what cells of the connective tissue can be expected? Whenever a vaccine is given to our body, what happens? What is the main system of our body which will fight against the vaccine, which will welcome the vaccine, which will talk to the vaccine, and it will have a good conversation with the vaccine? So you're taking any vaccine. So we have a system in our body which deals with it. Tell me, is that what system? Blood system? No. We have immune system. Then Inderbit Singh tell, let's go, we're going to study about immune system so that the concept will be very clear. You told me. Okay, right. Colvin, and he has given the differences in the immune system, what cells are coming forward, who are helping. So I am going for the fight, so I'm also calling my friends. Okay, who is the main guy who is going to fight, and who is the other guys who are coming back of me? Okay, so now we are going to start with the, like, we have two types of cells. We have plasmocytes and the lymphocytes. We have the plasmocytes and the lymphocytes. Take out that histology paper. We have the plasmocytes. Ravinash, parada.
Plasmocytes and
lymphocytes. Okay? We have the plasmocytes and the lymphocytes. Yes. See, these people are getting angry.